Welcome to our e-vidya. Dear students, last class we have all learnt about the sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. Today we are going to discuss about pollination. What do you mean by pollination? Through this student, the plant reproduce their young one. Okay. So how it is happened, we will discuss. The transfer of pollen from one anther to stigma of a flower. Okay. One anther to stigma of a flower. You think it is a flower, it is another flower. One anther to another flower. Okay, the transfer of pollen grains. I will tell you, students, through the image of the books. Okay, you can see here, students, the transfer of pollen from one stigma to another anther or one anther to another stigma of a flower. So this is called the pollination. The process is called pollination. Okay, one flower to another flower. So now self pollination and cross pollination. Pollination is two types. That is called self pollination. Another is cross pollination. What do you mean by self pollination, students? It is the pollen lands the stigma of a same flower. If the pollen lands on the stigma of a same flower. See, student, how it is a? It is a flower, student. It is that this shows a self pollination, this shows a cross pollination. How self pollination is happen? I will tell you. It is one flower. In one flower, that is pollens are there, stigma also are there, anther is there. This from that anther to pollen will grow if you that stigma of a one flowers of same flower is called self pollination. If like this will be happen if with two flower, then it will come say cross pollination. For example, if the pollens of one anther of a flower, if it will lands on another stigma of a flower, that is called, we can say, cross pollination. That means anther pollens of a one anther of a flower, if it will lands on another stigma of a another flower, it's called cross pollination. Means one flower to another flower, when pollen will be go and it will lands on the stigma, or that is called cross pollination. Understood? So if the pollen lands on the stigma of a same flower, that is called self pollination. Cross pollination means that if the pollen lands on the stigma of another flower, if the pollen lands on the stigma of another flower, that is called cross pollination. Clear, students? Understood? I hope all of you understood, students. Now we will go to fertilization, student. So what do you mean by fertilization? Clear, students? What do you mean by fertilization? We will discuss. Okay, the cell which result after fusion of a gametes is called zygote. Okay, after fusion of two gametes, it formed a zygote. Okay, that is called, comes under fertilization. Actually, the process fusion of male and female gametes to form a zygote is called fertilization. Okay. When what is fertilization, student? The process of fusion of male gamete and female gametes to form a zygote is called fertilization. The process of formation of a zygote or process of formation of fusion of male gamete or female gamete to form a zygote is called fertilization. So zygote develop into an embryo. So zygote develop into an embryo. It will develop to an embryo. That means we can say the male and plus female gametes will be converted to zygote. That zygote will be converted to embryo. Understood? Here you can say fertilization of zygote formation. You can say pollen grains will be reached here. After that, when will be fusion with ovum, it makes a zygote formation. It is becomes zygote formation. Pollen tube. The pollen grain will be comes through the pollen tube and form with a ovum to fusion with the ovum to form a zygote formation. Okay, so pollen grains mix with or fuse with the ovum, it makes a zygote. Okay, that is the male and female, they will both together mix a zygote. Okay, that zygote becomes, it is a embryo. ओके सो फर्टिलाइजेशन हैपेंस ऑन ओवरी दैट ओवरी इट इज कन्वर्टेड टू इनटू फ्रूट ओके अंडरस्टूड सो सीड डिस्पोजल व्हाट इज सीड डिस्पोजल स्टूडेंट्स सीड डेवलप फ्रॉम सीड इज डेवलप फ्रॉम द ओव्यूल आई नो राइपन फ्रूट इज ए ओवरी ऑल्सो राइपन फ्रूट इज ए वी कैन से ओवरी अंडरस्टूड एंड सीड डेवलप्ड फ्रॉम ओव्यूल व्हेयर सीड इज डेवलप्ड फ्रॉम ओव्यूल अंडरस्टूड सीड कंटेन एम्ब्रियो व्हाट सीड कंटेन एम्ब्रियो एम्ब्रियो इनक्लूज्ड ए प्रोटेक्टिव कोट यू कैन सी एम्ब्रियो इज कंटेक्टेड ए सीड सेक्शन ऑफ एप्पल्स यू कैन सी आलमंड दिस इज द आलमंड ऑल्सो सीड्स एंड फ्रूट्स आर ऑफ प्लांट्स आर कैरिड बाय द विंड एंड वाटर एंड एनिमल्स सीड डिस्पोजल मीन्स स्टूडेंट्स In nature, some kind of plants grow at different places. That happens because of seed they are dispersed into different places. So how it is? Formation, okay? Sometimes after taking a walk through a forest or a field or a park, you may have found seeds or fruits sticking on your clothes. Yes or no? So like this, seed dispersal means strength. Seed will be transformed from one place to another form through a, some medium. And where they will be transferred, there they will be reproduced and they will be form a new plants okay so it will happen through the such as seed and fruit and of plants are carried by wind water and animals wind some wind which seeds will be go will check drumstick maple and water coconut animal students xanthium urina so these are the some and sunflower also through wind it will go and means disperse means transform one place to another place okay some of the plants are some of the flowers are there their plants are developed through bast castor and balsam these are the some plants are developed through the balsam and castor are happens this happens in case of bast okay some seeds are dispersed when the fruits bast with sudden jerk the seeds are struck scattered far from the parent plant and this happens in the case of the castor and balsam understood students so this is the seed and this is the wing okay seed drumstick and maple we can say these are the and xanthium is a seed which is dispersal through the animals okay and urina also we can say urina example of carried by the distance place through the animals some seeds are dispersed by animals especially spiny seeds with the hooks which get the attached to the body of animal and they are carried to the distance of places example xanthium and urina so these are the seeds will be transferred or dispersed through the animal's body okay and where they will be fall down they will be their new plants produce from these seeds understood students I hope all of you understood students this is the little information student you have to write down from this it is very important I written okay so thank you students take care and study well I will send the question answer also you just practice go through it so thank you students once again take care